We're going to start with what is compact. And so let's consider a common problem in computing. We have a set of things like cards, and we want to filter that set to get a subset that we care about. So this comes up all the time. We might decide that we only want to do computation on the diamonds from this set of cards and take all the other cards and throw them away. We might select students from the roster of this class who have perfect scores on the programming assignments. My background is in computer graphics, for instance, so an example there. We might have a lot of objects to draw on a scene, but we only want to keep those that actually intersect the screen. We call this operation compact because we're compacting the large input set of potentially many items into something smaller. Another word for this is filter. Now, why do we want to do this? Well, if we only care about a subset of the input, and we want to run some computation on that input, it makes more sense to throw away the items that we don't care about and only compute on the objects that we do care about. We can rightfully assume this is both cheaper to compute and takes less space. We have a set of objects, S0, S1, S2, S3, S4, and so on. And we have what we call a predicate. That's this line here. Predicate is a function that inputs an S object and returns true or false for that object. So for instance, this predicate we're looking at here is my index even? So for S0, S2, and S4, the predicate returns true. For S1 and S3, the predicate returns false, and so on. We want to calculate S filtered by this predicate. So we only keep those objects in S for which the predicate is true. So what form do we want the output of this filter, of this compact operation, to be? We have a choice of how to do it. We can either have a sparse output or a dense output. For the sparse output, each element tracks to its same position in the output, and if an input has a false predicate, we just put some sort of null element in there. Alternatively, we can have a dense output, where all the elements for which the predicate is true are then packed together into the output, so they're all sitting right next to each other. There aren't any gaps in the output. In general, we want the output of a compact operation to be dense, and let me tell you why. So let's go back to one of the examples I cited earlier. Selecting the 13 diamonds from a deck of 52 playing cards and running a procedure called compute card on each of the diamonds. We could structure this code in one of two ways. We could either wrap our computation in a big if clause. So what we're doing here is on each card, we check if it's a diamond. And if it is a diamond, then we run compute card. Otherwise, we do nothing. This is the sparse approach. Or we could run a compact on the deck of 52 cards to get back 13 diamonds by running compact on the cards using the isDiamond predicate. And then run a map on the compacted cards, calling compute card only on the diamonds. So note that the sparse computation on the left side is going to launch 52 threads, one per card, and 39 of those threads will be idle. The dense computation, on the other hand, incurs the cost of the compact, but then in the map step, it only launches 13 threads. If the compute card routine is at all expensive, then the sparse approach loses, because we have to launch 4 times as many threads. 3/4 of those threads are going to be idle, while the other quarter of the threads are actually doing useful work. But because both idle and non-idle threads are running in lockstep, we're still paying the runtime cost of having 4 times as many threads. Therefore, generally, you prefer the dense approach, especially when this computation is expensive.